After the initial idea, I think thinking is my enemy.
Welcome to the Mixed Media Tapes. The Mixed Media Tapes is a short artist talk series based on word and phrase prompts. I have invited visual artists to select prompts from a list and share their thoughts and stories based on those prompts. In this recording, Joshua Barbosa talks about the mark as it relates to abstraction and the sequence of a work, and a bit more on the subject. Thanks for listening.
My name is Joshua Barbosa. I'm from East Providence, Rhode Island, USA. The mark relates to almost anything you're going to do. I mean, as far as art, no? Does it have to be a painted mark?
No.
Whether it's painted, whether it's drawn, whatever the case may be, is... I mean, it's essentially the backbone of anything you're doing, because, I mean, anything you put down, whether it's digital, painted, drawn, written, it's, you know, a huge part in conveying whatever it is you're putting down on a canvas or a piece of paper. So even if you're, you know, not painting something where, you know, the brush strokes are pronounced, maybe you're doing something like super realistic and you're using graphite and, you know, depicting something that you maybe you're working off a photo or something in real life, you're putting down marks, and every one of those marks works with the prior mark and the next mark that comes after that to convey whatever it is you're trying to convey. So, I mean, it's really abstract. Even if you're not making something that's abstract, you're applying marks in a way, and they all have to work off of one another to really come together and, you know, convey whatever it is you're trying to convey. Smudge, dab, blob, brushstroke, whatever. You know, not every mark has to be planned. I mean, I know for myself when, if I'm painting something, almost, short of maybe the first mark I put down, none of them are planned.
Yeah.
And they're all in response to one another. Those are marks for me more than anything. But still, I think, I don't think you have anything visual without some sort of mark, short of, you know, photographing something, anything. I kind of, like, the turning point for me with, like, I used to draw, you know, comic book type stuff and cartoons and whatever, and then I graduated high school and I went to school, and the like, hallelujah moment for me was when I was in the design class. I was like, oh, I hate this abstract crap. And then, you know, it really dawned on me how, you know, shapes and marks and everything is made out of a mark. A mark makes a shape, and that makes an image. So it's all, you know, they're all based off of one another. A mark, whether you're thinking of it consciously as a mark or not, is integral to getting your visual point across.
Yeah.
And like I said before, briefly, you know, a mark can convey something being hard, soft, or, you know, loud or quiet, or whether it's further back in the visual plane or closer up, or, you know, if it's thick and goopy or watery. It's like, you can just, everything you do on a surface is related to the mark. They are marks, but, like, you don't have anything without it.
Yeah. How far do you think the mark is from the initial idea?
For me, it's really, really far away from the initial idea. But, I mean, I think the initial idea for me only gets me so far. It only, you know, gets so much down on a surface before it's all about response. But, I mean, I guess there's still ideas, but you're bouncing them off of one another in real time. You're bouncing those marks off of one another in real time to, you know, get at whatever it is you're trying to, you know, make or suggest or emote.
Yeah.
To me, the most important part is not the initial idea, but what follows. What response you have to those marks from the initial idea and whatever just comes to pass in the time being.
Yeah.
Whether it's, you know, what color are you going to put down next, or, you know, how are you going to turn your brush or your pencil or whatever to make the next mark that either, you know, continues the painting or the drawing, or maybe it finishes it. Yeah. It's like, you never know. It's really, it's a completely unplanned sort of process. And I mean, that's how I relate to a mark. Yeah.